What's poppin', T Squad? It's me, Keisha. I'm here with tonight's All Tea, All Shade, Real Housewives of Atlanta review. Now, you know the show was gone on hiatus for 2 weeks, so I have a lot of tea that needs to be spilled. So, my first story on the Real Housewives of Atlanta. Remember a few episodes back, I posed the question about Porsha being shady towards King in her confessional. I was like, watch, it's going to be a problem with that moving forward. And sure enough, I was correct. So somebody had posed a question on January 19th. Oh, excuse me. Hold up, let me take a sip of water. If Kenya Moore and Porsha are rekindling their bond, why is Porsha being so shady on her confessionals? Excuse me, y'all, my throat is tickling. So, Kenya responded, that's the question I had too, or why she didn't take up for me. So, watch, that's going to be a part of the reunion. That question is going to be posed. Now, they're still very much cool. But, like I said, I knew I wasn't the only one noticing that she was being shady towards Kenya. And my whole thing is, yes, everybody on the show is shady. But with her and Kenya, it's a different level because they've always had a contentious relationship throughout the years. And I personally feel like if y'all are trying to start off on a new playing field, leaving the past in the past, there shouldn't be anything shady being said on anybody's behalf if y'all trying to start anew, because we all know that that friendship can deteriorate within a snap of a finger. Like, they still on thin ice. So I just feel like neither one of them should say anything shady about the other one. And to me, Porsha has been a little shady towards Kenya in her confessionals. And someone asked her about it on Watch What Happens Live when she was on the show. Asked Porsha.
Kenya for Porsha. Rhonda J wants to know why you pretend to befriend Kenya, but then you're so shady to her in your confessionals.
We're all shady. It's Housewives, girl. We're Housewives of Atlanta.
So that was her response on that. Okay. And regarding Wiggate, Kenya said opening the package is not in question. I called her so many times and she purposely didn't give it to me because she had a plan. Hashtag I never came for her. Hashtag Real Housewives of Atlanta. So she's saying that she reached out to Tanya several times to get the wig and she ignored her so that she could expose the wig on camera. She also said, let's keep it real, production. Cynthia told Tanya in Toronto and that's why she brought the wig. So she's saying that while they were in Toronto, Cynthia told Tanya about Cookie Lady. And we're going to have a lot more to discuss about Miss Cynthia. So also on Watch What Happens Live, Andy asked Porsha about Dennis being caught with four women eating breakfast at 4 a.m. in the morning. This is what she had to say.
Everywhere, people want to know how you feel about the rumor Dennis was seen out with multiple women. He was rumored to be with a group of women at an Atlanta diner at 4 a.m. Was that a blip in your relationship when you read about that?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Disrespectful. It's obvious it wasn't family members. He was some hoes he was hanging around. And it's obvious that she did not like that very much. So it's problems in Porsha and Dennis land again. I mean, how many times we got to tell this girl to leave Kermit the Frog the fuck alone? Girl. Ugh. Anywho, also in Real Housewives news, remember the whole thing with Nene and Wendy Williams 2 weeks ago when Wendy got on the show and said that Nene has some explosive news that's going to be brought up. And Nene was like, she said that Nene was thinking about quitting the show. And Nene got on the internet and said she didn't tell Wendy that and da 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 da. Well, allegedly the tea is, this person wrote into one of the blogs saying, I hope I'm not breaking any rules, but I have a few family members who work in reality TV in Atlanta. One who used to work for this show and another who does Kenya's makeup. All of their tea has always been accurate. Mama Joyce's streets are saying Greg has someone pregnant around the time he was diagnosed with cancer. Nene planned to leave then, but couldn't because of the diagnosis. Allegedly, he never stopped seeing the chick and Nene found out. This would explain a lot. The other personal information that Wendy alluded to but doesn't have permission to discuss is that Nene and Greg's New Year's Eve date was most likely the last. Word on Mama Joyce's street is that Nene never sees Greg and is all booked up for the next several months with her comedy shows and other projects. There really is no point in these two staying married anymore. What they have has not been a marriage for some time. I foresee some sort of an official announcement soon. Now, I don't know if Greg out here shooting up the club or not, but it would explain a lot of why she was so cold towards him while he was sick. We couldn't understand why she was making everything about her, why she was just being so mean and distant towards him. She didn't leave that man in the hospital by himself. It would also explain how if you watch Wendy Williams every day like I do, Wendy's always talking about how Nene calls her, Wendy, what you doing? She's always on the go. And I was always thinking like, why ain't she never with her husband? Why is she always out of town every weekend? So it would explain a lot of what's going on in their relationship, that maybe he was out here cheating on her. So let me know what y'all think about that little bit of tea, child. Also, it seems like Kenya and Mark might be working on their marriage. They were spotted together walking, holding hands. I don't know if they were in an airport somewhere, but they seem to be very in tune with one another, smiling and all those types of things. And she posted a video of him with their daughter on her Insta story. So it seems like they might be trying to work on their marriage. You know, I always say I want marriages to work out. Hopefully he can change and get his life in order, child. So that's all my tea on Real Housewives of Atlanta. We're all caught up. Now let's get into tonight's episode. So, alrighty. Oh, also, it's being alleged that Bravo execs are cutting the OG's salary. They won't just be doing yearly salaries anymore where they're giving out like $800 to $1 million per housewives just as a yearly salary. Now they're alleged that the housewives will be paid per episode, which means if you're not bringing it and if you're not in the episode, you will not be getting paid. So a lot of the OGs I've heard are really shooketh because, you know, they thought that they were here to stay. And now that, you know, Bravo has let go of Tamra and Vicky from OC, I've heard that a lot of the OGs are scared. Their positions aren't solidified like they used to be. So now they just can't rest on their laurels. They will have to bring it. So we're going to be seeing a lot of changes coming up with the storylines. A lot of people just ain't going to be able to sit back being cute no more. You're going to have to bring it. And I actually think that that's a good idea because some of these housewives have been being lazy. And that's on all of the franchises. So, on tonight's episode, the ladies go to lunch. Cynthia and Eva arrive first and are nervous about Kenya and Tanya meeting up to talk. Cynthia admits she told Tanya that Kenya was talking about her in Toronto at the table when she was talking about, you know, how would you feel if you found out your man was cheating? And that she told Kenya that she told Tanya. So Tanya arrives in this really cute Gucci ensemble. They tell her Kenya is coming. She didn't know that Kenya was coming before she came. So she says, you know, that's fine. She wants to squash everything with Kenya. Cynthia assures her that Kenya is not coming for her because if she was coming for her, she would have already did it by now. But boy, was she wrong. So Kenya arrives and they was like, you know, you look cute. You look pretty. And Tanya says, I'm glad you're here. And Kenya say, I actually like to look extra pretty when I'm about to read a bitch. And so everybody was looking like, well, wait a minute now. So Tanya mouth dropped because she was not expecting that. Tanya says, hi, Kenya. You know, she's trying to get her attention and Kenya keep on ignoring her. So she says, you know, the girls are coming to me and saying you're upset about the wig. Kenya say, that was some bullshit that you did. It wasn't cute. It wasn't funny. I'm a walking billboard. I don't know how you get your money. I don't know if it's from your boyfriend or whoever, but my money comes from my two hands. I trusted you to take something and give it to me. Well, let me finish. Tanya say, did you get it back? And Kenya say, the answer is no. What you did is you use it to embarrass me and discredit me. Tanya said, we all wear extensions. King says, no, I don't. Yes, you do. So Tanya's confessional look, by the way, is exquisite. I loved her new confessional look. Eva is shook by King's rap. She wasn't ready for it neither. King tells her that people will assume she wears fake hair all the time and that she's fucking with how she feeds with her daughter. Tanya brings up her Crash Marlowe event and this, this, and that. And then King calls her a cunt, which, and Tanya was like, girl, you are being too vulgar. And as far as this wig gate is concerned, King, you full of shit. You're wrong. The way you handled it, calling that woman a cunt, was going way too far. It was unnecessary. It was vulgar. It was nasty. You were doing team too much. She did not deserve that type of treatment for you to talk to that woman like that. Saying that you don't wear hair extensions, why would you lie and say that when it's obvious that you do? And it's okay to wear protective hairstyles and wigs and things like that. I don't know why she was such an about it while she was filming. Like, I don't see what she was up in arms about. Like, we all know that you wear hair pieces all the time, some of the times. We also know that you have very long hair. It doesn't matter. This is like Beyonce. Beyonce hair all the way down her ass. She's still gonna slap on a wig. It don't fucking matter. So I just felt like she was doing team too much. Did Tanya bring the wig to embarrass her? Yes, she did. Obviously, she was being shady. But I just feel like Kenya overdid it with this whole thing, and she was dead wrong for the way that she handled her. So then Kenya tells her that she was bothered by the conversation in Toronto. That's why she did it. Obviously, that's why Tanya did it. She knew that you were talking about her, so she tried to get you back. King say that girl brought the info to Cynthia talking about Cookie Lady. Cynthia say, she brought it to us. King say, but what you didn't tell her is that you invited the girl out with the other ladies. And we see that Cynthia invited Cookie Lady to her wine cellar open. I'm like, shady Cynthia. Cynthia's an old sneaky bitch. Now, she done took some of the shit I taught her while we was in our throuple and just took it and ran with it. I said, Cynthia, old funny bitch, you tried to let Kenya take all the heat knowing that you was playing in the cookie jar too. Now, Cynthia tried to act like she just invited the lady because she was next door. Nah, girl, you invited her more than because y'all right next door to each other. As far as businesses, you invited her because you knew that Tanya was probably going to beat her and some shit was probably going to go down. Like, stop it, girl. So, King says, because you wanted her to bring that back to Miss Tanya. Cynthia said, I was never trying to comfort Tanya. King in her confessional said, Cynthia never told me she had a conversation with Tanya that I needed to be on guard with her. Cynthia said, don't try to throw me under the bus. King said, I was only trying to help you. She said that to Tanya when I talked to you about your one egg. Tanya said, I felt that, she basically said she felt like she was being somewhat attacked. Now, we saw the conversation. King was not being aggressive in that conversation about her eggs. She had no reason to feel attacked. Now, Tanya, in that instance, you're reaching. You're trying to play victim right there. Nobody was being aggressive towards you. Cynthia was sitting right there. Y'all was having a general conversation. She was being nice to you. Now, I call bullshit on that part. Kenya say, now, bitch, bye. And then in walks Cookie Lady. When Cookie Lady walked in, y'all, I hollered. Now, Kenya tweeted tonight, she brought a wig, so I brought the Cookie Lady. Bitch, I died because they are petty as shit. So, Cynthia is mad that King invited her and that she tried to make it look like she used the info to hurt Tanya. But Cynthia, how you gonna be mad that she invited the Cookie Lady? You invited the Cookie Lady to your party. Why she can't invite the Cookie Lady to lunch? Shut up, kid Cynthia. So, Cookie Lady said that Tanya's man was single. Then Tanya's man told her he was single and that he did real estate. And at some point in the conversation, they kind of lost interest in one another. So Tanya, like, girl, you had a conversation at the bar. That's pretty much it. Now, Tanya, I understand that you're trying to save face, but at the end of the day, your nigga was in another bitch face trying to holler at her, and he said that he was single. Let's not gloss over the fact that your nigga's still out here wild, and that's why he ain't married your ass. Like, let's keep it a buck. But, you know, you did right save face in front of the next bitch, never let her see you pressed. So Cookie Lady say, don't be mad at me that I'm gorgeous and your man was looking my way. And I was like, girl, you cute, but Tanya look way better than you. You look like a little dry, shriveled up raisin now. That melanin ain't keeping you intact. That white side of you was coming out. So Cynthia makes it clear that the Cookie Lady told them about Tanya nigga trying to talk to her while the cameras, well, she thought the cameras were down. She thought they were down. So Tanya is, however, is impressed. But as the ladies are picking out cookies, like, you can see, like, she is, like, fuming. She's mad. She's embarrassed. But she's trying to keep it together. So Portia and Dennis go to therapy again. Portia says that ever since he put the ring back on it, it's been a mental block for her to have sex with him. She doesn't think that he realized how much she loved him before he cheated. I don't understand why you ain't been had a mental block to fuck that nigga. Ew. Like, bitch, I would have to fuck that nigga with a blindfold on, bitch. Him cheating that had nothing to do with that. So he says that he's not the only one that has work to do and everything's about him. And that Portia got shit she needs to work on. Girl, and the whole time he's sitting there, he was sitting there like, I'm so off this shit. I'm over it. Like, girl, you beating a dead horse with this nigga. He ain't ready. He ain't ready, girl. He full of shit. He ain't ready. So Ken and Mark go to Cynthia's wine cellar because he wants to throw a charity event. He walking around, like, trying to figure everything out in his mind out loud. And she's trying to add her two cents in. He keep on talking over her. He's just very into himself. She's just, like, there. And I'm like, Kenya, for you to be such a boss bitch when it comes to these bitches, well, you need to start getting your nigga in tech. Like, come on, sis. You supposed to be that girl. How you letting this nigga run over you? Like, Cynthia. Ken's one of them women that she wants somebody to dominate her, and she wants to be loved so bad that she willing to put up with anything, child. Girl, you need to learn how to love yourself, baby girl. Hopefully he can learn how to communicate and to treat others. Because, girl, you's a better bitch to me. So we find out that Cynthia's fiance is supposed to be hosting said event. So Candy wants to go back to acting. She has a role coming up on this third season of The Chi. Candy tells Todd that Joyce made Riley her beneficiary because she don't think that Todd would make sure that Riley was okay if something happened to Candy. He's like shocked by that. Candy doesn't know why things are going backwards again between Mama Joyce and Todd. He doesn't, however, want to deal with her either if some shit happened to Candy. I mean, if I was Todd, I wouldn't want to deal with Mama Joyce either. Like, ain't nobody got time to be fighting this old bitch. I do think, however, that he would do right by her kids. I don't think that that man would do them kids wrong. So, Cynthia is in L.A. with Mike. He has all of his friends come over, which we find out are all females. He has very few male friends. And Mike comes across like the type of guy to me that likes female appreciation. She didn't know that they were all pretty and never asked, has he ever dated any of them? I'm like, Cynthia, what kind of bitch are you? You supposed to ask questions, girl. Your nigga tell you he got a lot of bitches as his friend. You're not going to say, have you fucked any of them? Have you ever dated? Like, girl, these are questions that need to be asked. So, Mike has a tell-all book that's coming out that details, you know, all of his sordid history with cheating and this, and that. She said at first she didn't even think she needed to read the book. Why? Cynthia's so goddamn doe-eyed and dumb. So his friends say that he never posted a woman before Cynthia. They say that he's never been in love before. Now, mind you, his youngest daughter is sitting there while they're having this conversation. She got this look on her face. She's not smiling. She looks disturbed. She looks angry. Like, I'm like, why are y'all grown-ass people having this conversation in front of this girl? Like, sure, she's a teenager, but this still is a conversation that does not need to be had in front of her. And you can tell that she's visibly upset. So he admits that he wasn't a good man in the past, and that he's apologized to his daughter's moms for the way that he did them because he cheated on them while he was married to them. And Cynthia wonders, you know, if he cheated on his other wives, what makes me different? And I mean, what does make you different? So Mike says, obviously I've been married twice and I felt strong love, but I couldn't have been in love that much. Why in the fuck would you say something like that in front of your daughters? Whether it's the truth, whether it's something that you've already expressed to them, you don't say no shit like that in front of your kids. It's just that that's just, you just don't do that. You just don't go there like, come on now, like that's common sense, Mike. What the fuck is wrong with you? So his daughter head is down at this point and she looked like she's about to cry. And I was embarrassed. It was awkward. He tells her then to go upstairs. I'm like, nigga, too late. So she runs up the steps and everybody leaves. And he tells Cynthia he feel bad because he shouldn't have had that conversation around her. And I was like, duh. So he knocked on the little girl door and asked if he coming out. He was like, can Cynthia come? And she was like, oh, okay. He was like, you know, I apologize. I shouldn't have said that in front of you. What can I do to make it better? She was like, nothing. And she starts to cry. And then they leave out the room and he hugs Cynthia. And he says he feels bad. And I was just like, you get an F, nigga. Like, that was stupid. He just made me so mad. It was just so inappropriate. So overall on tonight's episode of Housewives, I give it an A for tonight's episode. Make sure to thumbs up this video, like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell button, you guys. Thank you for watching this video. I love you and I'll see you on the next one. Make sure you watch my Shots of Sunset review. It'll be up next. Bye.